Supplement 1. Troubleshooting and no colony syndrome. In the case you don't get your clones from the first time, I want to suggest a couple of troubleshooting ideas. The first one deals with the case when you have no colonies on your vector plus insert plate on the next day after the transformation. In most cases, the lack of colonies on the vector plus insert plate can be tracked to lost DNA, either of the vector or of the insert. To test that, I prepare an agarose gel and run 5 microliters each of the vector and of the insert DNA. On this gel picture, you can see relatively intense bands for both vector and insert. However, if one of your DNA fragments is barely visible or missing, it would most likely cause low efficiency of ligation. If that's the case, try to identify a step where you lose the DNA or prepare the DNA fragment again. Another reason for having no colonies on day 2 is the low quality of plasmid DNA. An easy way to check for the quality of plasmid DNA is to retransform 1 microliter into the competent cells. If you get a carpet of colonies, like this one on this plate, then your plasmid DNA is good. However, if you just get 10 or 20 colonies, it would indicate a low quality of plasmid DNA. In such a case, pick one of those colonies, prepare a fresh plasmid mini prep, and try to clone your insert into a fresh plasmid.